Mandibular second premolar is the fifth tooth from the midline. Its tooth number in FDI system is 3, 5 and 4, 5, in universal system 20 and 29, and in Zsigmondy-Palmer system it is 5 with appropriate quadrant brackets. Function of mandibular second premolar is grinding. Coming to measurements, the crown length is 8 mm and root length is 14.5 mm. The mesodistal diameter is 7 mm and at cervix is 5 mm. The buccolingual diameter is 8 mm and at cervix is 7 mm. The curvature of cervical line at mesial side is 1 mm and on distal side it is flat. Next, the chronology. The tooth erupts at the age of 11 to 12 years. Morphologically, mandibular second premolar is present in two forms. The three cusp type with three cusps is more common and develops from five developmental lobes, and two cusp type with two cusps, which is less common and develops from four developmental lobes. Here we will be discussing the three cusp type in detail and mention the differences in two cusp type. So let us study the morphological details from each aspect, starting with the buccal aspect. The outline form of the crown is trapezoidal in shape. Only the buccal cusp is seen, as the smaller lingual cusps hide behind it. The tip of the buccal cusp is slightly mesial to the midline axis of the tooth. In comparison to first premolar, the cusp of second premolar appears blunt and rounded. The distal cuspal slope is longer than the mesial cuspal slope. Both the contact areas, the mesial contact area and distal contact area, are in the middle third. Both mesial and distal outlines are slightly convex in shape, as is the cervical line with convexity towards the root. The buccal surface is smooth and convex with the prominent buccal ridge running from the cusp tip to the cervical line. The two cusp type mandibular second premolar from the buccal aspect appears exactly the same as the three cusp type. Coming to the root, a single root is seen, which is smooth and conical. Next, the lingual aspect. The features of the outline form from the buccal aspect are same in the lingual aspect as well. Additionally, all three cusps, mesiolingual cusp, distolingual cusp and buccal cusp, are seen. The buccal cusp is the largest and the distolingual cusp is the smallest. A small groove is seen running vertically between the two lingual cusps, called the lingual developmental groove. In two cusp type, there are only two cusps, one lingual cusp and one buccal cusp. The lingual cusp is smaller than the buccal cusp. There is no lingual developmental groove. Next, the mesial aspect. The outline form is rhomboidal in shape, which is same in all mandibular posterior teeth. Two cusps are seen from this aspect, the smaller mesiolingual cusp and larger buccal cusp. The tip of the mesiolingual cusp lies outside the confines of the root, just like that in the first premolar. Both buccal outline and lingual outline are convex. The crest of curvature of buccal outline is at middle third. The crest of curvature of lingual outline is at occlusal third. The mesial margin ridge is seen running horizontally between the two cusps. The two cusp type appears exactly the same from the mesial aspect, with both buccal cusp and lingual cusp seen. Next, distal aspect. All the features of outline form from the mesial aspect are same in the distal aspect as well, except that from this aspect, all three cusps are seen. And as the distal marginal ridge is lower than the mesial marginal ridge, more of occlusal surface is visible. In the two cusp type, both cusps are seen. Finally, the occlusal aspect. The outline form of the crown is square shape. All three cusps are seen. The largest buccal cusp, then the mesiolingual cusp and the smallest distolingual cusp. Coming to the ridges, each cusp has two cuspal ridges, one mesial cuspal ridge and one distal cuspal ridge. Then each cusp has one triangular ridge running from the cusp tip towards the center of the crown. Two marginal ridges, mesial marginal ridge on the mesial border and distal marginal ridge on distal border. Fossa. There are two fossa present. Mesial triangular fossa adjacent the mesial marginal ridge and distal triangular fossa adjacent the distal marginal ridge. There are three pits, mesial pit in the mesial triangular fossa, distal pit in the distal triangular fossa and a central pit located in the center of the occlusal surface. There are three developmental grooves, mesial developmental groove running between the central pit and mesial pit, distal developmental groove between the central pit and distal pit, and lingual developmental groove running from the central pit in between the two lingual cusps and ending on the lingual surface. These three grooves converging on the central pit make a Y-shaped pattern which is characteristic of mandibular second premolar. In two cusp type, there are only two cusps, one larger buccal cusp and a smaller lingual cusp. The outline form is oval-shaped. Only two pits are seen, mesial pit and distal pit, there is no central pit. Only one groove, the central developmental groove, runs mesiodistally between the mesial pit and distal pit. The shape of this central groove makes two forms of two cusp type of mandibular second premolar. In H form, the central groove is straight. In U form, the central groove is crescent or U-shaped.